here tonight. I want to thank the Academy for asking me here to conduct one of my favorite bands of all time. It's also a pleasure to be here. Thank you guys, because I've been sitting out there and watching a lot of my good buddies, musicians and friends that are not with us anymore. And I'd like to say something to those of you that are watching. To honor the past and the people that have been here is a great thing. It's a wonderful thing. But I don't want the Academy to lose sight that what tonight and all of these events are about is educating the new and young generation. So we never lose. Never lose the intention, the great invention of rhythm and blues and soul music in America. They say life isn't fair, but you would think, given the amount of great influential music made by the Five Royals, over 80 plus singles to their credit, they would be as popular as some of the more successful groups of the 50s, like the Coasters and the Drifters, and also the Platters. God bless them all. The Five Royals were the most integral part of the sound of that era. They began as a gospel group, the Royal Sons Quintet in 1951, just a few days ago. And it was only a few years later, in 1953, when they recorded Cover Somebody. 3 years, count, three. 3 years before historians credit the point in time when Ray Charles was breaking ground in soul music. Got my name. The best thing about the Five Royals is how their voices both blended and stood apart. Johnny Tanner, as you know, if you've ever heard him sing, is certainly one of the greatest soul voices from that era. The remaining group included Eugene Tanner, James Moore, Obadiah Carter, and featured the great singing, songwriting genius and guitar player, Bowman Paul. Started getting favorable recognition. The Five Royals toured well into the 60s. Bill with the Miracles, the Isley Brothers, Dion Warwick, and many others. Their music has influenced artists like James Hunter, and you heard him say earlier, Jimmy Bond was influenced, Stevie Wonder, Eric Clapton, Mick Jagger, and let's not forget the all-time classic rendition by him, the master of the king, Ray Charles, a song called Tell the Truth. Tell the truth. In the early 60s, glad I'm still here to talk about it, I was fortunate to see the Five Royals live at the Beverly Ballroom at Clearwater. That's a place where kids would go swimming in the summertime. Fortunate thing, my high school band was playing at a club downstairs. And we asked the owner, could we go up and see the Five Royals? Because we were like giant fans of the Five Royals. And he said, well, you guys are too young. You can't get you up there. Because there we were playing in his club, underage. Well, the good news about Memphis, Tennessee in those days, it was a brown bag. Brought your booze and you bought setups. And he said, I'm gonna get you guys up there. And it was Duck Dunn and myself. And we had to stand way over in the corner and watch it, but we got to see the Five Royals. I went home that night after that show and started walking around in my closet, and I guess I woke my mom up, and she said, what are you doing? And I said, I'm looking for a belt. And she said, a belt at 1 o'clock in the morning, what? And what I was gonna do was put two belts together and give me a long strap like Bowman Paul and play way down by my knees. And I did that for a while. I had never seen anybody play a guitar. I've never heard anybody say like this man watched me over here, Mr. Bill Withers. God bless you. They've been nominated before like many others, but tonight is the night they are being inducted for their influence in all of music, not only rock and roll, soul, R&B, jazz, and all this. So it gives me a sincere pleasure to finally induct. They wanted to be known as the Royals, the Five Royals, and they had to change their name. And this jockey is called them the Five Royals. We always called them the Five Royals. It's my pleasure to induct them into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.